everyone, April here. Happy Wednesday. I hope you all have been enjoying the power effects and 60-second videos I've been putting out, but today I'm back at you with another full-length video. In this video, I wanted to talk about how we can start moving our SharePoint-based Power Apps applications into Dataverse for Teams. Now, there are many reasons why you might want to move off from SharePoint-based applications and Power Apps to utilizing Dataverse for Teams. I'll cover what some of those reasons might be and how we can actually physically move the SharePoint list data into Dataverse for Teams and even our applications in there. All that coming up right after this. So let's start by talking about why you might want to consider moving off of SharePoint as your data source for your Power Apps into something like Dataverse for Teams. To help explain this better, I put together this table walking through SharePoint, Dataverse for Teams, and the full-fledged version of Dataverse, and some differences that we have between the three. One of the big distinguishing factors here is on the type of data that the three store. With SharePoint, as we know, it's a great collaboration tool, and we can use it to store files and collaborate on files, and even tabular data with SharePoint Lists. The key with SharePoint, though, is it's not a relational database. And that's a distinguishing factor between it and Dataverse for Teams and Dataverse. With those two options, you're getting relational data storage. And what that really means exactly is, as the name implies, you're able to easily define relationships between different tables in your data. So if you had a table to store customer information and another table to store contacts for a customer, and you want to be able to associate those two, that's native and easy to do in a relational database like Dataverse for Teams, Dataverse, and SQL Server. With SharePoint, there isn't a relational database. Now, you can fake it with things like lookup columns, where you can create a quasi-relationship, but it's not truly a relational database. Therefore, it's not going to be optimized for things like that. The other thing we have to consider here is the client. Now, with SharePoint, we have a variety of ways that we can actually access our data in SharePoint. So obviously, if we're using the data in a Power App, that's one way. We have the Microsoft List application. There's a SharePoint application for your mobile device. There's the desktop itself to get into the browser and access SharePoint. And we can even access that data with inside of Teams and through custom code. With Dataverse for Teams, however, the only way that we can access the applications and the data that we have behind that is with inside of Microsoft Teams. So that could be one reason why you may or may not want to utilize Dataverse for Teams. In one way, it's great because if you're already using Microsoft Teams for everything and you want a holistic experience with all of your business data and your processes and applications in one central place, it's great for that. But if you want to use it beyond that scope, Dataverse for Teams might not be the fit. Dataverse, the full-fledged version of the Power Platform's database and data model, is available on a variety of clients as well. So we can leverage this in our Power Apps Canvas apps, which work both on mobile, tablet, and desktop, inside of model-driven applications, Power Apps portals, Dynamics 365. Also in Microsoft Teams, we can embed the applications we build that connect to Dataverse on Microsoft Teams, and through custom code. One of the other things we have to consider here is licensing. Now, one of the reasons why SharePoint is such a heavily utilized data source for Power Apps applications is because we get that included for free with our Microsoft 365 business licenses, and we get that what we call seeded version of the Power Platform included in that, which lets us access non-premium data sources such as SharePoint, Excel, and all that. One of the great things about Dataverse for Teams, though, is we can also leverage that seeded M365 licenses to be able to build applications inside of Dataverse for Teams and take advantage of its relational data storage. So we don't need any additional licensing here beyond what you're already using to build Power Apps based on SharePoint. And one of the great things about it, though, is we get one extra thing that's really key when it comes in terms of connectors. So if you ever want to connect to data that is not currently available in one of the 400 plus data connectors out there, maybe it's a custom API that you have, we could create custom connectors for that. But those fall into premium licensing territory, so we have to pay for the associated license to use any of those custom connectors or premium connectors. With Dataverse for Teams, however, If you're hosting APIs inside of Azure API Management, we can use that connector and consume those services inside of Dataverse or Teams for free. So again, yet another reason why you might consider shifting from SharePoint to Dataverse or Teams. If you need to consume data from another API that you can host in Azure API Management, if you shift that to Dataverse for Teams, then you won't have to incur any additional licensing. And then of course with Dataverse, that is the top premium tier, so you will need to pay for the Power Apps either per user or per application plan to be able to access the full-fledged version of Dataverse. But with that, you get access to all of the premium connectors. Now we talk licensing, and at the same time, we have to talk about capacity, because that's another important distinction. This is where it can get a little tricky, because with SharePoint, we're kind of subject as far as sheer capacity to the SharePoint limits, which are pretty big. We can have up to 30 million rows in a SharePoint list, and that's a lot, and 25 terabytes of data per site collection. Now, while that seems like a ton of data that we can physically have, the problem is when we're using that in context of Power Apps and the Power Platform, is that only so much of that data is realistically accessible and usable inside of Power Apps due to something called delegation. Power Apps tries to offload handling the data to the data source itself so that you're not doing a lot of heavy lifting inside of the client. That's better for performance. But with that, you have a few trade-offs, meaning that we have these things called delegation limits where depending on the actions you're trying to take, like maybe filtering a list by the current date, if assigned to is not equal to me, things like that, then we're restricted to only being able to query at a time 2,000 rows of data. And SharePoint has some of those delegation issues that we have to keep in mind about what we can realistically access in an application we're building. With Dataverse or Teams capacity, this is another thing that you want to keep in mind when considering to move to it. If the application you're building, the solution you're building, you don't expect to go over 1 million records per environment that you're hosting it in, then Dataverse or Teams is a good choice because we have that 1 million record limit. And it's either 1 million records or 2 gigabytes per environment, whichever comes first. So we're subject to those limitations, and right now there's really no way to add any additional capacity. So you have to make sure the apps you're building, if you want to use Dataverse or Teams, are going to fall under those capacity metrics. And with Dataverse, the other thing we have to consider is API limits. We do have a limit in Dataverse or Teams of 2,000 API calls per user per day. And an API call would be if you're using Dataverse or Teams and you're writing data back to your table in Dataverse or you're reading data, things like that, does require API calls and go against that limit on the per user per day capacity. So that's another consideration with capacity. How often is this going to be used, the application that you're building? With the full-fledged version of Dataverse, the API capacity limit is similar with the 2,000 API calls per day per user. However, we do have the ability to purchase additional capacity there. And with the full-fledged version of Dataverse, we have no row limits and we can store 4 terabytes of data per environment. So that would be a reason right there where you would consider moving off of something like SharePoint, Dataverse, or Teams into the full-fledged Dataverse is capacity alone. And this is another important distinction. With Dataverse or Teams, if you do host your applications there and say you do grow out of it, you're starting to reach those capacity limits, there's an easy path to transition your applications from Dataverse or Teams into Dataverse. And finally, we gotta talk about security. Now with SharePoint, this is often one of the things that left a bit to be desired. We were subject to the SharePoint security rules and limitations here. We could use the Microsoft 365 group and Azure Active Directory security, but we can't realistically do things like item level security. With Dataverse for Teams, security model obviously is very focused around the Microsoft Teams security model, so it respects the Teams owners, members, and guests permission model. And we also have the ability to share those applications we built in Dataverse for Teams with Azure Active Directory groups. With Dataverse for Teams, we're still not going to have that very granular row level security though. We need to go to the full-fledged version of Dataverse for that. Because with the full-fledged version of Dataverse, we get the benefit of a very robust security model that lets us do custom security rule, handle business units, hierarchical and field level security. So hopefully this really explains where we might use each of these main data sources and some of the reasons why you might consider moving to Dataverse for Teams. So let's take a look at an actual use case now. Say you want to move this time off request application inside of Dataverse for Teams. Right now, this is tied to SharePoint, and it has a few different SharePoint lists that it uses for its data sources, namely this time off request list. It's going to be a two-step process to get this application into Dataverse for Teams. First thing we'll need to do is take our underlying SharePoint list and move those into Dataverse for Teams with something called data flows. To do that, we need to go inside of Teams and open up the Power Apps application for Teams. If you don't have that installed already, go to your left rail, click the Apps tab, do a search for Power Apps. You'll see the app there, and click Add instead of Open here. When you open it, you'll want to go to the Build tab at the top. This is going to show you a list of all of your teams which currently have Power Platform environments associated with them. So if you don't see it on the list here, that means there's not an environment. An environment will be automatically created when you try to add a Dataverse or Teams Power App or bot to that team. So select the team that you want to move the solution to. So I'll choose this super awesome team. And then you'll have a few tabs across here on the right-hand side. Built by this team is where all of the applications and the tables and things that you create will show. Data flows, though, is where we want to go if we want to import data into Dataverse for Teams. So we can add a new data flow here. And you'll see we have many different ways that we can import data from different systems like Excel, but we want to choose the SharePoint online list. We want to go back to SharePoint and copy the URL of our SharePoint site and paste that here in the site URL field. I already have an existing connection here, but if you don't have one, you'll have to set up a new connection. That just requires you signing in with your credentials and choosing an authentication privacy option like private or organizational. Then you'll click Next. Now on the left-hand side, we'll have all of the lists and libraries that are in that SharePoint site that you provided. So we'll just select this time off request list for now. And when we do that, it'll show us a live preview of all of the data that's in there. So now we can click Next, and then we need to transform our data, meaning we need to choose what columns we actually want to move over and make sure that their data types here match up to what we're expecting. So first thing I want to do is go to Choose Columns, and choose columns again, and I'm going to hide any of those unnecessary back-end fields that we have in SharePoint, like this file object, content type, and all of that. Now that we have that there, we can click Next, and this is where we go and tell it what we want to do with this data. So I want to load this into a brand new Dataverse table, so I'm going to keep this default option selected, and then I'm going to keep the defaults for the table name and display name as well. Then I'll confirm that my source columns map to the right column type, and we'll see what the destination column name is going to be. At the top, we can choose a unique primary name column. It can auto-generate one called name, or we can use one from our data source with this dropdown. So for example, I could reuse the title field for that. Now all we have to do is click Publish, and this will set up the data flow, and behind the scenes, it will create that table structure inside of a Dataverse or Teams table and import the associated data. Depending on how much data you have, this could take up a little while, so I'm going to use the power of video editing and fast forward to once this is done. So now it looks like it's done. We see we have a published message and the refresh is done. So we should be able to go back to this built by this team tab and see a brand new table in here called time off request. Now if we click in that, we can see the columns that were added inside of this table and verify that they all came across okay. And then we can click this edit data option to see if our data also got moved over. And it looks like it did. I see all of those records that were in the SharePoint list here in our new table. So there's half the battle getting the data into Dataverse. Now, one thing I want to point out with these data flows is within Dataverse for Teams, these are one way. This is how we can get data into Dataverse for Teams. If we use the full-fledged version of Dataverse, those data flows that we have in there can be used bidirectionally. We can use a data flow not only to pull data into Dataverse, but also get data out of Dataverse into another system like, say, Azure SQL. So one thing to keep in mind when we're talking about comparing the feature functionality. Also with these data flows in Dataverse for Teams, we can't automatically refresh them, but we can go in and manually refresh them. So if for some reason you've continued to use that SharePoint list and you've already moved it over here, you can actually go in and do another refresh to get the latest data. So now that we have that table moved over, how do we move an application that we've built in Power Apps Canvas app as a standalone application into Dataverse for Teams? Well, when we're here at the Power Apps application in the Built by This Team tab, you should see an option at the bottom for See All. And if we click that, we're taken to a different screen where we have some more options here. One of the options that you'll notice on this screen here in the ribbon is an import button. This actually allows us to import a solution into Dataverse for Teams. So if we go back to make.powerapps.com, and then we'll need to go to the Solutions tab and create a new solution if the app that you want to move over isn't already inside one. So I'll create a new solution called Time Off and click Create, and then we'll want to go and add in that Canvas application into the solution. So we'll click into that new Time Off solution, choose Add Existing, select App, and then Canvas App. Then we'll want to go to the Outside Solutions option if it isn't inside a solution already. And we'll select the app here, which is called Time Away, and click Add. Now that that's there, we can choose the Publish Customizations. Once that's done, you'll see a success message here. Now we can choose the Export option to take this solution and export it as a managed or unmanaged. We're just moving the Canvas app, so we're going to choose the Managed option and click Export. And this will give us a zip file that we can then import into Dataverse for Teams. Now we can go back into Teams, make sure we have that Import button selected, click Browse, and choose our new managed solution that we exported. Click Next. And you see it's showing the Canvas application as part of the solution there. And now all we have to do is click Import. So this is going to bring everything over. So one of the things about Dataverse for Teams to point out as well is while it gives you the ability to use Dataverse as your data storage, since this application that I have is using SharePoint, which is standard features, this app will work just fine when I import it in here in Dataverse for Teams using SharePoint data. So if I needed to mix and match and still keep some of this data in SharePoint for whatever reason, but then some of it in Dataverse, we can do that. All right, so that has finished importing now. Let's round this out and let's see what that installed application looks like. Now you'll notice it doesn't show up here on the Built by this Team tab. That's because we didn't build this within Dataverse for Teams. We installed it as a managed solution. So that means it's gonna show up here in this installed apps tab instead. So we can see this solution. Now we only had one Canvas app as part of that, but this could include some flows and chatbots and tables as well. Now, if we want to see what's in the solution, we can go to See All. Then we'll see our Canvas app here, and we can click on the three dots and edit, and that will actually open up this imported application in Dataverse for Teams inside of the Power Apps editor so that we can make any changes we need. So it looks great. Looks like everything moved over correctly. And if we look at the data tab, we can see all the data sources we have in there. Now we just carried over the SharePoint list data sources, but we can mix in our Dataverse for Teams table that we just added into here by clicking Add Data, and we'll see our Time Off Request Dataverse for Teams table that we can add in. So now all we have to do as part of this process then is to remap some of the functionality that I have in the app to point to this new Dataverse for Teams table instead of the SharePoint list. And then when we're done, all we have to do is publish to Teams, click that button in the top right, confirm the name and the title and all that, click Next. Select the channel where we want to deploy it to. So I'll just put this in the general channel of our super awesome team. Save and close. And now if we go into Teams here and we just open up our super awesome team in the general channel, we'll see a new tab for Time Away. And that will open up our brand new imported Power App with our Dataverse for Teams table included. Well, that's all that I had for you all today. Thanks so much for watching. And if you found this helpful, do me a favor, click that subscribe button and the thumbs up. And I'll see you in the next video.